Okay, so the tripod is broken since my last video. I mean, not completely broken. I can still wedge it to stand up, but I'm not going to be able to do an intro like that for a while until I can afford a new tripod. And I just had to pay a bunch of bills and spend about $100 on parts for this truck that I didn't want to spend, but it's easier than trying to harvest them off of that one over there, the old 83 Blue Dodge. So what we're up to today is this. More wiring. I got, where the hell to go? This thing, it just arrived last night off of Amazonia. At first I thought it was night, but it's actually nylight. Nylight? I don't know. I thought it was night, but evidently it's nylight. Anyway, it's got an engine start button that'll be illuminated when I press it, I guess. I can wire it either way. I don't know. I probably won't wire it up. Or maybe I'll wire it up so the lights up and the headlights are on. Nah, that'd be stupid. All it's got to do is send 12 volts to that relay right there, this red wire. I'm at a loss for words. Okay. So, get in there and look. See a 30 amp fuse? Heater AC. Okay. Heater AC starts the fucking truck. I'm so damn confused right now. I don't know what the hell is going on. Something in this ignition switch, I think, but I'm not sure. So, in today's episode of Arts and Crafts with Ben, I mean cardboard aided drafting, CAD, whatever you want to call it, turn a chunk of this thick-ass old computer side panel into this with a hole in it, because I don't feel like trying to cut old brittle plastic. And, you know, I might decide to undo this one day when I actually cover the hole that I created in the dash by removing this. So I'm going to try to turn this, or that, into this, or something resembling this with a hole in it for that panel. So basically the way I'm going to do it is this sits under the steering column. You know, like that. And then this thing's gonna sit in there like that. And it does, if you look at the footprint, fit quite well. So that's where it's gonna go, because that's near where all the wiring I need to be at is. Okay, I clearly stuck with the grinder, so let's try this again. Let's try this again, shall we? Might have to put the damn handle on the damn thing. Yeah.
cursing some profanity, anything is possible. Damn, that is ugly. No, I wasn't talking about you neither. That shit is ugly. And trust me, I got a good reference. I'll look in the mirror every day. Could I make a better one if I tried again? Yeah, I'm sure I could. Do I care? Nah, I'm sure I don't. So, we're just gonna, you know. It can't run if it's laying flat, right? Sure. That'll do. That's going somewhere. I don't know where, but it's going somewhere. Sure. Okay. See, I don't have a fuse right now, but it should still. Yep. Now we can connect these ground wires to these, to this, to that. And eventually it'll all get tied up in there. This is gonna angle of the dangle through here somehow. Stereo wiring. And I even dug up this out of my dad's truck. Damn light bulb for the radio, for the AC controls, I mean. This fit kit piece that'll let me put a radio in there. Kinda, sorta, like that. It's not the best, but it'll work. And I just runs like a tractor. As you would expect. Long last, the promised drum brakes. I really hate these things. I'm not replacing everything in here. I'm just doing the wheel cylinders and putting parking brake cables on. Because the parking brake has to function for Virginia State Safety Inspection, and I can't go putting antique plates on this thing and expect not to be pulled over. Because they're going to start cracking down on that shit this year. Fucking whore. Finally! Ah, you bastard. There we go. There it goes. Oh no, wait, the pin sheared off. Great! Well, that's one thing I won't harvest. I'm gonna need new pins. Or no, it didn't shear off. It's fine. Good! It's a little bent. Well, that happened, but. Got one new parking brake cable installed back here. Rebuilt this wheel cylinder. It's off that truck over there, because the new wheel cylinder, wherever the fuck it went,
I used parts out of it to rebuild the old one, because it was damaging shipping and I don't know where it went, but it was around here somewhere. Oh god. No, here it is. Yeah. And that lip got broke off and it was torn. So, I think this is the torn one. No, that's one of the bad ones off the old one that was bulging. Anyway, with random parts I laid around, that wheel cylinder's rebuilt. The other one's gonna be new, probably. Or rebuilt. It's all on there. I still gotta bleed them once I get this back together. Oh, I had a dime getting this back together. It did not want to cooperate at all. Speaking of shipping damage, holy shit. So unfortunately, I didn't get as much done as I wanted to on the truck this week. I got one parking brake cable changed and one wheel cylinder rebuilt. You saw why I had to rebuild it. It was damaged during shipping, the new one. So I just took all the guts out of the new one and put it in the old one. The old one was in really good shape, but I figured, hey, I got new seals and springs and everything. I might as well throw it in there. It's gonna have one new wheel cylinder, one rebuilt, tomato tomato. As long as they're not rusted out in the middle, doesn't matter. Anyway, I didn't get as much done as I wanted to this week. Just been kind of a chaotic week. Some electrical, some of this, some of that. Next week's video will have me finishing up the parking brake cable, maybe, if I film it, I don't know. It's really tedious working on brakes, takes a really long time, and then I forget my phone's recording and it ends up going dead, and you know. But I'll try to record bits and pieces of it as I go. Anyway, there'll be more to come on this truck next week, but that'll be it for this week, because it's Thursday now. I drop these videos on Friday. Friday's my day off, but it's going to rain off day Friday, so, you know, I can't really work out here in the rain. I could, but I'm not going to. Really don't want to. Thanks for watching.